to the next and final talk of the conference. So the title is Public Key Cryptosystems, Resilient to Continuous Tampering and Leakage of Arbitrary Functions. By Eiichiro Fujisaki and Keita Sagawa from NTT Japan. Right. And the talk will be presented by Eiichiro. Are you using this microphone?
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Thank you for your introduction. My name is Eiichiro Fujisaki. This is joint work with Keita Kusaga from NTT Secure Platform Laboratories. First, a part of this talk is closely related to Antonio's previous talk. We also analyze Queen Liu PK scheme in the tampering attack with a different setting. And also, impossibility result to signature complement their result on signature. And this is the agenda of my talk. First, we have already, Antonio already explained the tampering attack, so we just briefly explain, tampering attack is a just attack to that allows the adversary to modify the secret of a target cryptographic device and observe the effect of the change at the output. General, Riskanatskaya, Malkin, Mikari, and Rabin, and Berare and Kono are the first, provably secure system against tampering attacks. Yeah, of course, tampering attacks are known before, but they are the first provably secure, they make us first provably secure systems. And And just consider mount a tampering attack on the NDCCA game. Adversary can now send a tampering function file with a cipher text to the decryption oracle, and decryption oracle now returns a decryption of cipher text under the modified cipher text, modified secret phi sk, and that case the goal is equivalent to the NCCH game, and that case in this paper we focus on the tampering attack with arbitrary function. Then some restriction are required. There is strong impossibility result. There is no IND-CCA secure PKE or nor EUFCM secure signature scheme resilient to unbounded polynomial memory tamperings of arbitrary function, even the stronger model than CRS. So proof is very simple. Just consider this kind of tampering queries. Then, by querying these functions, adversary can retrieve the whole secret key from the output of decryption or signing oracle. So, and to bypass that impossibility result, one way is to only allow a bounded number of tampering queries. The Antonio's talks categorized in this, and another way to avoid this attack to allow an unbounded number of tampering queries, but to allow a device to self-destruct if it detects tampering. This is called a continuous tampering with a self-destruction mechanism. This talk belongs to this category. And also, yet another way is to allow unbounded number tampering queries, but allow a device to update its secret key. It's called continuous tampering with key update mechanism. And one of our scheme belongs to this category. Now, also, there is a further classification, persistent tampering and non-persistent tampering. Persistent tampering means a tampering is applied to the current version of the secret that is overridden by the previous tampering function. Just see this, like this. If queries like this, in this order, then adversary get obtain this kind of result. Then another type of tampering attack is non-persistent tampering attack. Tampering is always applied to the original secret. That case, for the same series of queries, adversary receives this kind of result. Here, do you remark? If we allow we cannot allow a key update, then no persistent tampering attack is always stronger than persistent attack. Because one can simulate a persistent query in the non-persistent attack. And if we have a key update, then it is unknown which is stronger. So there is another impossible result to specific to public key encryption. There is no IndCCA secure PK scheme resident to even one post-challenge tampering query of arbitrary function. Choose this kind of one tampering function, then you can break indistinguishability of a public key encryption scheme. This attack is unavoidable even with self-destruction key updating and bounding the persistent non-persistent tampering attack in the more strong model. So in this paper, we concentrate on the CRMS model because we can treat tampering of arbitrary function. If with a weaker model than CRS, then we must restrict the class of tampering function. So we concentrate on the CRS model. Now, this is a summary of previous work. This talk consider this our result is we show the first CCA secure PK scheme resident to continuous tampering of arbitrary function, and one is a continuous tampering and bounded memory leakage, and one is a continuous tampering and continuous memory leakage with a key update mechanism. And also we show the impossibility result. There is no signature scheme resident to continuous non-persistent tampering even with a self-destruct mechanism. And if key update mechanism works only when a tampering is detected, there are no signature scheme even with a key updating mechanism. This is our result. So, go to the continuous tampering and bounded leakage CCA scheme. Now, just the definition of continuous tampering bounded leakage CCA game. It's similar to the bounded tampering leakage CCA game. The only difference is adversary may submit unbounded many tampering query to the decryption oracle, and until the decryption algorithm self-destruct. Decryption algorithm self-destruct when it rejection symbol. Then in that case, adversary cannot access the decryption oracle anymore. First, just consider Just consider a bounded leakage CCA PK scheme. Yeah, this means in the CCA secure PK scheme, resilient to bounded memory leakage. And that kind, if that kind of, for any bounded leakage CCA secure PK scheme, this hold, if the size of message is smaller than the limit of bounded leakage, then any bounded CCA secure PK scheme is resilient to at least one bounded number of tampering. Yeah, of course, trivial this is. Because one can simulate tampering oracle by using a leakage oracle as like this. So, however, this does not work for continuous tampering. And even for bounded tampering, this black box usage is very, gives a very bad band. So, Anthony also does not use this kind of things. Now, to go to the construction, we prepare two primitives. One is a hashproof system. Anthony also already explained, and also previous talk also explained hashproof system. So I just almost skipped the explanation. Anyway, Lambda is a project and gamma entropic hash is called a projective and gamma entropic hash. And the hashproof system means there is a evaluation, public evaluation algorithm and private evaluation algorithm to output of projective and projective hash. This is very popular system, so I skip the explanation. And also, I use a all but one injective function. Yeah, this is just in the previous presentation, this is called one-time lossy filter named in the Queen and Liu paper, but this function is just a weaker version of all but one trapped function. Where trapped function is just replaced an injective function, and let A be a ABO function. It's a public, it's a kind of public key, and only one tag. A on T is lossy, while all other tags, A on T prime is injective. And one cannot distinguish lossy branch T from the injective branch T prime. That is assumed by definition. Now, just go back to Queen Liu PK scheme at Asia Crypt 2013. Queen Liu propose PK schemes and which is industry CCA secure and resilient to bounded memory. Anyway, that means bounded leakage CCA secure. Queen Liu scheme is constructed by combining a hashproof system plus all but one injective function. Actual construction is like this. This is M is a message, K is a hash key of a hashproof system, and hash key is filtered by all but one function, and VK is a one-time verification key of one-time signature, and sigma is a one-time signature on the first four items. Yeah. So our claim is that put hashproof system parameter and all but one injective public key of all but one function in the CRS, then Queen Liu scheme is a continuous tampering and bounded leakage CCA secure if it has a self-destruct mechanism. Proof is very simple. First consider this kind of a very simple lemma. For any random variables, this equation hold. Proof is easy, like this. Then, just consider the query ciphertext of Queen Liu PK. And K-star is a challenge hash in challenge ciphertext. In the simulation, C-star does not belong to V, so K-star has a large entropy. And then when CD submitted to the decryption oracle with a tampering function phi. Decryption oracle compute this, and if this is ciphertext is rejected, then what is revealed from K star? This is just this. This for case one is easy because decryption oracle just output rejection symbol. So case one immediately follows from the useful lemma, but how about case two? Case two is a decryption oracle does not reject ciphertext. So decryption oracle also reveal message. This must have entropy. So, however, the entropy of that message is actually zero given ciphertext because this function is injective on the challenge on the VK. Therefore, this kind of inequality holds and case two holds. So now, let Pi be a probability that D does not reject ice query ciphertext. Let PL be the probability that D rejects S query ciphertext. Note that there is a trade-off between leakage bit log of 1 over p and probability p. Namely, if p log of 1 over p is big, then p is small, and vice versa. So if the total leakage bit from all tampering queries is exceed omega log k, or is omega log k, then probability that occurs is just negligible. So Queen Liu PKE system reveal at most omega log k bit against tampering attack with overwhelming probability. So to sum up, Queen Liu PKE system reveal at most omega log k bit against tampering attacks. Queen Liu PKE is a proven bounded leakage secure and can afford order k bit memory leakage. So combine this, Queen Liu PKE is a continuous tampering and bounded leakage secure. This proof can be applied to Antonio's scheme also. And now we go to the continuous tampering leakage CCA secure PKE scheme. Just consider continuous tampering bounded leakage security, CCA security notion does not imply in CCA security notion because the decryption oracle self-destruct even when it receives an invalid ciphertext, it receives an invalid ciphertext and the original secret escape. The reason is that decryption oracle cannot distinguish tampering query from a normal decryption query. So, the continuous tampering leakage CCA security notion implies a, however, continuous tampering leakage CCA security notion implies an in the CCA security notion, so it's better. And just a definition, PK is a key update mechanism. This is very simple. It's first three algorithm forms a standard PK and update. There is a key update algorithm takes SK and update it to the new secret without changing PK, such as PK is called a PK with a key update mechanism. So continuous tampering leakage CCA game is almost easier to follow. It's just the difference is instead of D is a D self-destruct, D update secret key, and Also, leakage query, leakage query is a, this red part is a different part of the continuous tampering band leakage game. Yesterday, you can easily imagine games. So I skip the, and now we just go back to the phi queen leap PK scheme is like continuous tampering and banded leakage secure. Remember, queen leap PK scheme is constructed by combining hashproof system with the all but one function. Hashproof system makes a banded leakage CPA secure PKE, and all but one function transform BLCPA secure PKE to BLCCA secure one. It is proven by a queen and leap. And also keep it small to reveal a secret key by answering one tampering query. However, although leakage is small for one tampering, it is leaked step by step, so the self-destruction is needed. The decryption algorithm can detect the tampering before it reveals too much. So, observation, if there is a hashproof system with a key updating mechanism, then by combining it with a all but one function, we can construct a continuous tampering leakage CCA secure PKE. Now, so there is no such a hashproof system, unfortunately. So we, but Aguirre's, Dodge's, Weikenthaler-san, Wick's PK scheme is very close to this, such a hashproof system with a key update mechanism. Their scheme is a hashproof system-based PK scheme resilient to continuous leakage in the floppy disk model. Floppy disk model is there are two secret keys, and so one secret key that is not revealed and is not only used to update a secret. So goal is to modify the secret key update algorithm in the floppy disk model to one in the key update model in the sense of Brakelsky et al. Means, such as this kind of things, without USK. So there are two steps. Hashproof system in Aguirre is defined on the ordinary prime order group. We translate it in the binary groups, which makes it possible to key update without other secret. For security proof, we modify the random subspace lemma. Aguirre version of random subspace lemma is like this. And we proved random subspace lemma in this world. Then we succeed in constructing scheme. Impossibility that there's no EFCM signature scheme to resilient to unbounded polynomial many non-persist tampering of arbitrary function, even with a key destruction mechanism. This is easy to follow. Just the adversary make this runs a key generation algorithm to make a two pair of legitimate algorithm and set this kind of function. So for query this, the adversary can obtain ice bit of SK, but the signing oracle cannot detect tampering, so she cannot self-destruct and repeat the whole secret. Now, conclusion, it's a summary again, and this is comparison, and this is preference, and this is thank you for listening.
Thank you very much. Maybe a short question or comment? Right, so let's thank all the speakers from this section again. And this concludes our session, so enjoy the farewell lunch.
Thank you all. And I hope that you enjoy the conference, the friendly atmosphere in Hanoi, and the night weather. And so now we have lunch and have a good trip back, and see you next time. Thank you.